Marine Corps Lieutenant Colonel Jasmine Moghbeli has always dreamed of exploring the stars. And now it's becoming a reality. With years of training under her belt, this scientific research mission is scheduled for launch on August 15th, marking her inaugural voyage into space. Military Times' Jonathan Lehrfeld caught up with the astronaut before her journey. Have a look.
And I'm Jonathan Lehrfeld with Military Times, and very interested in hearing more about your story and your career from being a Marine to joining NASA. So I have a handful of questions for you.
Okay, I'm ready to go.
Well, I'd love to hear more about why you decided to first join the military and when you decided to transition from that career path to NASA.
So I was interested in joining the military from a pretty young age. I was also interested in becoming an astronaut from a pretty young age, and thankfully those two things worked out together very well. I wanted to join the military for, I think, a variety of reasons. One, my family had a history of military service in Iran, and I remember my grandfather coming to visit us in the States and telling me about his time in the Navy when I was younger. So from a very young age, I had that interest. And then the idea of service to country was something really important to me. You know, my parents came from Iran, so I think I was very aware of the opportunities this country has given me. And then teamwork. I've always played on sports that were team sports, and so that idea of camaraderie really appealed to me.
Would you say that the process of becoming a Marine or the process becoming an astronaut has been more challenging?
I'd say probably becoming a Marine was more challenging. You know, for me, a lot of my time in the Marine Corps, I think, is what set me up for this experience not to be as challenging.
I think you just touched on this, but were there experiences from your time in the Marine Corps that have lent well to your work as an astronaut?
There have been so many things from my time in the Marine Corps that carry over directly and have served me very well here. From basic things such as leadership skills, working together as a team. You know, I have the honor of serving as the commander of the Crew 7 mission on my first space flight. And I think that is partially due to the fact that I learned those leadership skills from the Marine Corps. Everything we do at NASA is as a team, and especially on orbit, you know, there are just a little over a handful of us living and working together for long durations. So learning how to do that. My time as a test pilot has served me very well. This is a time in spaceflight where we have more new vehicles and different vehicles than we've ever had before. And looking at how we humans interact with those vehicles and the interface between is something that I learned directly from being a test pilot, to basic things like public speaking. I used to be terrified and have horrible stage fright, but in the Marine Corps, I had to brief every single time I flew a flight, brief over and over and over again. And so eventually I got comfortable with it.
Are there things that you've learned from other folks who have preceded you, like Colonel Nicole Mann, who also was a Marine, is a Marine, and then transitioned to their time as an astronaut?
Yes, Colonel Mann has been a great resource for me. We try to connect and talk on the phone probably every couple months, and then message in between. And anytime I have questions, I'm pretty quick to reach out to her. But she's been a great resource for me, especially also serving as the commander of a spacecraft Crew Dragon, SpaceX Crew Dragon, on her first flight as well.
What impact do you think that your experience and Colonel Mann's experience will have on other women service members or women in general who are interested in joining the astronaut corps?
I hope it's something that just shows women and service members out there that this is something they can do, and not only something they can do, but something that the military has probably set them up very well for. So I hope they just recognize that this is a door that might be open to them as well.
Well, thank you. I know you have limited time. I appreciate it, and have a good and safe trip.
Thank you. Take care.